Asslamualikum, hello, hi, and once again welcome back to my kitchen. With me cooking is fun with Firdaus, and today we are going to make a veg recipe, and that recipe is one of my favorite recipe. It goes very well with the rice, and it goes very well, I'm talking about the vegetable which we are going to use. It goes very well with the rice and it goes very well with the chapatis and parathas. Okra, you call it Bhendi, and in Tamil it's called Vendakkai. And we are going to do two recipes with okra. One we are going to do that you can have it with rice and dosa idli, and one we are going to do that you can have it with parathas, naans, chapatis, rotis and all that. So let's quickly start with the recipe.
So guys, we will be making bhendi ki kadai, which goes very well with rice, and dry bhendi masala, which goes very well with chapatis and parathas. As I said earlier, we'll be first cleaning the bhendi and then cut off the edges and then chop them in any sizes and shapes if you want, and divide into two. The first recipe we are going to do is kadai. So for that, in a pan we'll add around 1 to 2 teaspoons of oil along with garlic, cloves and onion. Ingredients in the description box, guys, so please have a look at it. Once the onions are translucent, we'll add green chillies along with tomatoes. Now cook these well so they are all blend together and it becomes translucent, and then add around 1 to 2 teaspoons of coriander leaves and 1 to 2 tablespoons of freshly grated coconut and some salt. Cook until they are well tendered and translucent and they ooze out some oil from the sides. And now once this is done, set aside, and moving on to the dry masala which we will be grinding. Here in a pan we will be adding whole garam masala like bay leaf, cinnamon stick, cardamom, clove, along with some seeds, coriander, cumin, red chilli, some garam dal and freshly grated coconut, around 1 to 2 teaspoons. Now nicely dry roast all these ingredients well. Once you have dry roasted it, set this aside for cool as well. So let them cool down, and then we need to blend both of these separately. First I'm going to blend the dry one. So let me add it to the blender and blend it coarsely. You can see that. And I'm going to just take it in a bowl or a clean container where I can store it. So once this is done, moving on to the other part, I'm going to now grind off my onion and tomato mixture into a fine paste. Here I'm adding around freshly grated coconut, 2 to 3 tablespoons, and grinding it with some water into a fine paste. So everything is ready. Moving on. In a nice clean pan again, add around 1 teaspoon of oil along with some mustard seeds, some curry leaves and hing and some red chilli. Once this is done, we will add the okra to it, the bhendi. Now we will cook this bhendi until they are nice crispy from outside. And you see guys, since we wiped and we cut it, there is no layer of chipchipa, that oily thing in the okra. Now we'll add the masala which we grinded along with some half a teaspoon or 1 teaspoon of red chilli powder, turmeric powder and coriander powder. Mix it well, and then we will add the masala, the onion and tomato paste which we have grinded earlier. So as you see, once you mix it, let it cook for about 2 to 3 minutes and then add the grinded coconut paste or milk. You can add anything. And then you can add around 3 to 4 teaspoons of curd for the tangy flavor of the curry. So around 2 to 3 teaspoons, and then some salt. Give it a nice mix. I think the curry is little thick, so I'm going to add around 1 glass of water to it so that it gets cooks and it becomes a little thicker from what the consistency is right now. So after 5 to 10 minutes in a medium flame, I'm checking my curry is ready. I'm just going to drizzle some coriander leaves and it's ready to be served, guys. So let's move on to the next recipe now. The next recipe is bhendi dry masala. Yes, this is one of my favorite, which goes very well with my chapatis. So here in a nice clean kadai, I'm going to add 1 to 2 teaspoons of oil along with some nicely chopped or sliced onions. and I'm going to cook until the onions are translucent, and then I'm going to squeeze the tomatoes and add it because it gives real good flavor to the onions when the tomato liquid gets well cooked with onions. And then the same dry masala which I grinded, I'm just going to add 1 teaspoon because I like the flavor of ground masalas, so I'm going to add it. Now once this is cooked well, I'm going to set this aside. Now take another nice clean pan, add around 1 teaspoon of oil with some chopped or sliced or smashed garlic with some curry leaves, and again little oil for me to give tadka of hing and rye, that mustard seed. And again I'm going to cook the bhendi. This method is followed for any recipe for the bhendis especially, so that they don't ooze out the oil and they become chip-chippy types. Next, take back the same kadai in which you cooked the onion and tomato and add the bhendi to it and mix together and cover it and cook this for about 5 to 10 minutes in a very very low flame. After 5 to 10 minutes you check your bhendi is not discolored and your flavors are amazing now when you taste it. It's tempting me now. And now it's ready almost. I'll just drizzle some coriander leaves. So once this is done, let me show you. Just have a look at it. It's cooked completely. Now comes the serving time. I'm going to serve this with some nice homemade chapatis which I made just now. They are right now very hot. So I'm just going to serve this with some nice chapatis. And then I'm going to serve the curry with some nice steamed rice. There you go. The aroma is so beautiful. I mean, tasty. It's tempting me. Moving on, have a look at the pictures and I'm going to take my bite.
Okay guys, the food is ready now and I'm going to have a bite from this and you are going to watch it, but you are definitely going to try this and share your experience in making this type of bhendi masala and bhendi curry, and do share in the comment section below. So let me quickly give it a try. This is amazing. You should definitely give it a try. Right? So. The flavors are amazing. You should definitely try this recipe and share your experience in the comment section once again. And I'm going to serve myself. I'm very hungry, and you people keep watching for more videos. Cooking is Fun with Firdaus, and stay tuned with me. Allah Hafiz.